Free agency is always an exciting time in the NHL, either for the right reasons for landing a big name for your franchise, or for the wrong reasons by signing a player who is deemed overpaid before even putting on the team's jersey. This year's free agent frenzy is going to be a weird one for sure, and there is pretty good talent available in this one, especially on the blue line. But unlucky for these free agents, there's a flat cap, less time to make these decisions with off-season timelines being changed and unpredictable, and some teams even being rumored to have a lower set cap for their franchise specifically due to the lost money, leaving a lot of GMs with their hands tied and a more unpredictable market from it. Hey, it's Matt from Puck Rivals, and in this video, Billy and I are going to go over some of the bigger names in this unrestricted free agent group and give you our picks for where we think they might end up. This is all speculation, so be sure to leave a comment where you think these players could go, and with that, let's get right into the video. Starting off with the forwards, we have the biggest name in winger Taylor Hall. He's coming off an okay season in terms of his ability, having to adjust to a new team after being traded mid-season. In Hall, you have an elite winger with dynamic scoring ability, and someone coming off of a 7-year, $42 million deal, and is definitely looking for a raise from a $6 million per year cap hit. The three potential spots we have Hall going to are the Colorado Avalanche, New Jersey Devils, and Arizona Coyotes. The Avs don't have any major signings to do this offseason, and are a great team with lots of potential that could lure Hall into even taking a slight discount to go on multiple cup runs with them. The Devils have lots of young talent, and is a place where he had an MVP season before. And the Coyotes definitely had hopes to sign him earlier in the season, but with all the drama going on in the organization and the absolute slaughtering that the team suffered from the Avalanche, it's going to be tougher for them to pull this off. Next up we have scoring winger Mike Hoffman. He has scored over 25 goals 5 times and would be a great addition to any team's top 6. He's coming off a 4-year deal making over $5 million per year. The three potential spots Hoffman might end up are the Florida Panthers, previously mentioned Colorado Avalanche, and Boston Bruins. The Panthers have plenty of cap space with room for Hoffman to keep the same spot in the team's top 6. For Colorado, he would be the more affordable option if the Avs don't go for Hall, and who wouldn't want to go play for that team right now? And for the Bruins, they're a great team every year, and Hoffman can add some scoring depth behind the perfection line, playing with David Krejci. The final forward we have from this free agent group is Tyler Toffoli. He's coming off a 3-year deal, making $4.6 million per year. The three potential spots we have Toffoli going to are the Vancouver Canucks, Los Angeles Kings, and Nashville Predators. Toffoli fit very well with the Canucks after being dealt to them at the deadline, so why not stay with an up-and-coming team with lots of young talent? The LA Kings are a team with a great prospect pool and will be a contender again in a couple years, and not to mention a place where Toffoli spent most of his career and was a Stanley Cup champion. The Preds still struggle with scoring depth, and Toffoli can help them with that. They are a team with lots of skill in every area, and if they can put it all together on the ice, are a big cup threat. And now Billy is going to take over and do the top defensemen and goalies available in this free agent class.
To begin the D-men of this free agent class, we'll start with the biggest fish in current St. Louis Blues captain, Alex Pietrangelo. He's coming off a shortened season, still racking up 52 points, and is one of the best two-way D-men in the league. His last contract paid him $6.5 million per year, so you bet he's looking for a big upgrade in salary. The three teams we see signing him are his current team, the Blues, the New Jersey Devils, and the Toronto Maple Leafs. The Blues will need to find cap space to retain their captain, and maybe signing Justin Falk to a 7-year deal wasn't the best thing to do. New Jersey could really use a top pairing D-man like Pietrangelo, and the Leafs have needed a top pairing righty for quite some time now. They would just need to find a way to have another big contract fit in. Moving on, the next D-man available in free agency is Torrey Krug. An offensive puck mover, Krug put up 49 points this year in 61 contests, and was paid $5.25 million. The three suitors we have for Krug include the New Jersey Devils, Montreal Canadiens, and Detroit Red Wings. The Devils' biggest need is on the back end, and Krug could move the puck to their young skilled forwards. Montreal has needed a top lefty defenseman for some years now, and along with Petrie could be their main puck mover. As for the Wings, they need help everywhere, and Krug could go home to Michigan, get paid nicely as they have the cap space, and be the number one guy. The third D-man I'll be going over is Tyson Barrie. Barrie had a relatively rough contract season in Toronto, so he'll need to use his past few seasons as leverage to get a pay raise from $5.5 million. The teams we can see going for Tyson Barrie include the Red Wings, Winnipeg Jets, and yet again, the New Jersey Devils. We have the Red Wings really because they can easily afford to pay him and might be able to pay his ask due to that, as well as their pretty weak decor. For the Jets, their right-sided defense could be stronger than it is, so Barry could slot into their top four on the right and provide some offense. Lastly, the Devils yet again, as they need D help, and an offensive guy like Barry certainly will help their young forward succeed. Let's move on to the pending UFA goaltenders. To kick it off, we'll start with Jacob Markstrom, and he deserves a pay raise after his stellar rise to being a starting goaltender. Vancouver has some decisions to make, and Markstrom could be the one they let go due to the Seattle draft and Thatcher Demko's playoff emergence. Still, the Canucks are in our three suitors for the Swede, along with Ottawa and Detroit. If Markstrom re-signs, the Canucks will likely have to say goodbye to either Chris Tanev or Tyler Toffoli, but it would be a good reward for Markstrom to sign back with the Canucks as well. Ottawa desperately needs a goalie. They've got prospects, but they won't be ready to go for a while, so Markstrom can be a good stopgap until one of them can take the reins. As for the Red Wings, it could be similar. They have the space to pay him, and don't really have a goalie prospect that is ready to make the leap, or even a good NHL starter for that matter. The next tendy we have is Robin Lehner. This man is a warrior. Ever since fending off his demons, he has become a true starting goalie in the NHL, and deserves to get paid this offseason. It does seem likely that he re-signs in Vegas, which seems like a very good fit for him. But for the sake of this video, the other two suitors other than Vegas could be the Senators again, or the Oilers. Lehner would be in a similar position as Markstrom if he returned to Ottawa, just being a very, very good stopgap and mentor for the younger goalies coming up. As for Edmonton, Mike Smith is a pending free agent, and Lehner would certainly be an upgrade over both him and Koskinen. The last player we'll be going over in this video is goaltender Braden Holtby. Holtby, in my opinion, will likely be the cheapest to sign out of the top three goaltending free agents. This would probably be a mix of him being older than them and coming off of two pretty down seasons. There could be quite a bit of teams in the mix for his signature, but the three most prominent to us could be Buffalo, Ottawa, and Edmonton again. Buffalo has been searching for a goalie for quite some time now, and Holtby seems like a decent fit for the Sabres. He would be cheaper than the other two, and has plenty of experience that he can provide to the team. As for Ottawa and Edmonton, their situation with Holtby is pretty par to the course with what I said for Lehner. A stopgap for Ottawa, and an upgrade over Mike Smith for Edmonton. At this point, this is just speculation and giving our opinions on where these players might call home next. Let us know in the comments where you think the top free agents are going to sign, and if you agree or disagree with our assessments. Free agency is slated to open at noon Eastern Time on October 9th, so we'll have to wait and see how things develop until then. If you enjoyed this video and love hockey as much as we do, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons, because that's what we do around here. This is Billy from Puck Rivals, and I'll see you guys in the next video.